What is up, dudes? Geesa, what's up, man? Glitch Gaming TV, yes. Hello and welcome. Boogum! Gapshida! Orenmai. We are in Aspen today, flying the Premier One. I did a test flight to make sure that it worked with Vulcan, and it does. I did have an issue with the Saab 340. What's up, Ashton? How you doing? So I flew the Saab 340 and tried to do an ILS, and was on vectors to final and got deflection, picked up the localizer, got deflection on the CDI. So right when I got near the localizer, I switched it to approach mode. For whatever reason, the deflection switched to the opposite side and the plane started turning around. So I had to do it manually, just flying by hand. Fortunately, it was like VFR conditions. It wasn't a big deal. But I think there's an issue maybe with carenado, perhaps, with some instrument approaches. So we're going to plan on doing an RNAV into Jackson Hole. I think winds last time I checked were 330, so we're gonna land runway 1 instead of 19, and hopefully it'll be okay, unless we get failures in between here and there and we crash somewhere in the mountains. I don't know. Also, if you have what's it called, XP Realistic, if you had version 1, version 2 just came out, and if you check your accounts on the X-Plane store, it'll give you a discount coupon, so it's only $4.99 to upgrade. So I got that. There is some new stuff, particularly for helicopters. There's blade slapping now, and you can choose different types of helicopters. So it has a different sound profile for a Huey versus like a Robinson R44 or something. There's also a sneeze, which I turned off. I don't need that. I can do that in real life. And wind ambience, which you can kind of hear now. The interface is better. You can save different types of profiles. Some of the sounds have been improved, but it's not like super different. Got to do touch and goes at Tambo in South Africa, which is extremely rare as it is a main airport due to the virus. We're allowed to do a few touch and goes. Nice. Actually, something that you can do if you have your student license and you can fly solo, or if you have a private license, at least here, like if you went to Hartsfield, for example, which is the big airport here, it's a Class Bravo, you can actually do touch and goes at night when traffic is down. So I haven't done it. I have a friend that did it. So maybe one day I will head out there and give it a go. Anyway, I haven't done anything, so we're going to go ahead and get a GPU connected. I can do the flight plan. So we're going to do... Oh, that's loud. We are going to do the Pitkin 4 departure, Eker transition, then to OCS, BPI, and then to KJAC. Once we get a little bit closer, I'll figure out what runway we're going to be using, and I'll load an approach just to see if it works with this airplane or with Carenado stuff and Vulcan. Anyway, let's do battery, get that on, go avionics 1 and 2. Dismiss. ATIS.
Kilo Alpha Sierra Echo. Airport information Charlie 003.
Doing pretty well, man. How about yourself?
Zulu. Weather wind 001 at 4. Visibility 10. Sky condition temperature 7. Dew point minus 9. Altimeter 3033. Advise on initial contact. You have information Charlie
3033.
Kilo Alpha Sierra Echo. Airport information Charlie 0037. Zulu. Weather wind 001 at 4. Visibility 10. Sky condition temperature 7. Dew point minus 9. Altimeter 3033. Advise on initial contact. You have information Charlie.
Alright, information Charlie. I'm going to take off runway 33. Clearance delivery. Listen for Alpha. Transponder code. And get on ground. 12.9. Oh, there you go. 11 10
Canada 6044.
And ground was 0.9er. 121.9. Oh, wrong one. Happy Friday. You guys got weekend plans? What's going on? And let's get a flight plan in here. We are going from Aspen, Kilo Alpha Sierra Echo, to Jackson Hole, which is one of my favorite airports. Kilo, Juliet, Alpha, Charlie. I think the only non... we got two.
Bravo, Oscar, 723.
Oscar, Charlie, Sierra.
Tractor 245, hold for Bravo 3.
Bravo, Papa, India. And we're going to do departures. Pitkin 4.
Canada 738, heavy ground gates occupied. Taxi hotel.
Runway 33, right, Pitkin 4, Eco Transition.
Hotel 15, right.
And we'll execute that. I'm not going to put in an arrival. There is no, there's like an arrival procedure, but you don't have to do those unless I think you're visual. Because the approach procedures for runway 19 and 1 both give you terrain clearance, so it shouldn't be an issue. Another tour. Some of the problem that I have is that I only have ortho scenery for the United States, so it'd have to be in the United States because I'm not flying in that trash default scenery. You know what I'm talking about? Make sure that looks good. Runway 33, Clinton, slalom, Eker transition, BPI. So before BPI, we're gonna need to put in an approach, and we'll fix that there. Let me look at the departure procedure for Aspen.
Retard, retard, retard.
Melon!
I'm
guessing Melon. For some reason, my activity feed disappeared. Oh, Glitch Gaming. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it. Departure. Pitkin 4. Takeoff minimums, runway 33. 400-foot ceilings, 1 mile visibility, minimum climb of 500 feet per nautical mile. I'm not even going to try to figure out the climb gradient here. I'm 100% we can do it, even at this altitude.
Because
we're a jet, boy. 500 feet per nautical mile to 16,000. And 16,000 is going to be at Glenno. So at or above 16,000 at Glenno. Which is 2, 4, 18, 28, 30 nautical miles. That's easy. So we got to climb about 9,000 feet. 9,000 feet in 30 nautical miles is doable for us. It is GPS, RNA aggregate. We can do it. And I think we're in the BRR 2. Is the, for whatever reason, this is weird, but apparently Greg Minsk, the guy who is Premier 1 pilot, said that that's right. So VR 2 is set for GPS. I don't know. Not a thing. FMS is selected there. Or maybe I guess that's the next one to select. And what is our runway heading? Just in case, runway heading is 330. So if you guys want to do another tour across the United States from different spots, I'm down for that.
Lufthansa 495 heavy ground runway 24 right information Zulu taxi Delta 3 Charlie.
Figure out what airplane to do it in, where start and end point be. Holy moly! Thanks, dude. Very generous, appreciate it. Runway heading 330. I think we're good for startup. And again, when we get everything started, I'll turn on the failures. I'm not gonna turn those on just yet. Oh, and let's do this as well. I'll get our arrival altitude. I think it's 6,400. I will double check. KJAC, show plate, airport diagram. 6,451, so we'll round up. There we go. Perfect.
Maple 769, give way to Lufthansa off the ramp at DQ.
We're on ground. And tower on standby is
118.85.
Something else I need to do is uninstall and reinstall the XATC chatter, because that is... it's like repeating messages for some reason. It started a long time ago, and I've just been too lazy to fix it. All right, let's turn off the avionics. Brother, you are on a roll today. Thank you, man. Okay, avionics are on. Where'd my little menu go? Ground power disconnected. Turn on our beacon. Make sure all these guys are off. I'll probably help if we remove the static objects as well. I'll double check. The parking brake is on. Yes. It's over here. There it is. Static objects. Close the door, please. And double check. The beacon's on. All right, we're good to go. Fuel pumps on. See if I can remember how to do this. Once we get this split needle, go ahead and turn the generators on and reset this. On, reset. Double check. And we got voltage. Noise. Split needle, left gen on, reset, and voltage. Good job. Get our avionics back on.
Canada 173.
Anti-skid,
normal.
Stall warning,
alpha.
Stabilizer.
Alpha hotel.
Pedo and static on. We'll turn windshield on low. Don't think there's going to be much clouds between here and there. Set takeoff trim here too. While we're thinking about it, unlock our, what is that, lift dump? Let's see if I can remember which button I mapped lift dump to. That is the one. Set up the auto, I'll actually get the failures on real quick. Flight configuration. Wrong one. 350 done. Apply. And set up our autopilot. So 16,000. We're just going to go and climb to our cruise altitude. So we're going northwest. So it's going to be an odd 1,000. So let's go 30. We'll go 33. Flight level 330.
Tractor 245 Bravo 3. Tractor 245 ground tow, tango crossing wave, 3 to right, hold short echo.
330 and vertical speed. Actually, we'll do flight level change once we get airborne, but double check. Probably do 2000. Hopefully. And we're going to leave that in
Maple 7699,
nav mode.
12207.
Maple 7699, good night.
Alright, double check we got here. Vertical speed, roll. I think we might have to wait to select nav until we're airborne. And altitude is selected. I'm going to set the speed for 250 just for visual reference, although we're not going to be below 10,000 for too long.
And Airtime 73, do you mean Fox 3 to tangle, or not quite sure if Fox 3 needs to tangle and not Fox?
And another thing we're going to do, just in case we have some sort of GPS failure, we go US IFR high flight. I'm going to put in the VOR frequencies just in case. So the first one is EKR, which is 115.2. Make that active.
715 heavy ground taxi Delta Alpha, hold short Alpha Kilo Cross 338.
Okay, Delta Alpha.
Oh, he's self-quarantining. They exposed to the virus, so they have it, or are they sick, or what? And then OCS,
sorry,
Rock Springs, 1160.
Did you ask me something earlier?
Yeah, sorry, I thought it was in the power frequency, but it's okay, thank you.
Oh, okay.
Suits up your nav, we'll do here. Nav 1, 115.2 we got, and 116.0 for Meeker. Bam. Alright guys, I think we're ready to roll here. Little flight control tests. Good enough for me.
146 ground, good day, runway 23, 8 is Juliet, altimeter is 2984, taxi Alpha, hold for Alpha Kilo.
Park and brake.
Taxi Alpha, hold for Alpha Kilo, speak at 293.
Let's go.
146.
How long did you stay home for? 2 weeks? Out of our controlled movement area, check that the slip skid indicator is working. It is. Setting takeoff laps, but you guys weren't looking.
Grand Encore 3539 with you on Charlie 4.
We are going to Jackson Hole, Wyoming. It's like 360 nautical miles.
Delta Echo Short here, Encore 3539.
Go, go, go! Gaza! Quata! Mogul Shipta! I'm hungry. Holy cow. Yeah, I should do another flight here. The instrument procedures are pretty fun. I mean, if you start like a descent from 13,000, you gotta put your gear and your flaps down because the climb gradient's so steep. Or the descent, I guess, to keep you from overspeeding. It's pretty fun. And generally only lands 1-9, which is the direction that we're headed. So we're going to take off runway 33, but I'm pretty sure they usually are only going to land 1-9, because obviously terrain in front.
Charlie Fox.
Piper Aero video? Yeah, I'll throw one in there this week.
Alpha. Tango. Cross runway 33 right. Ultra Echo. Alpha Tango, cross 33 right. To Echo Fox 8 Golf. Thank you, Fox Short Golf. For Fox 8 Golf, I see it is. Hold short, Echo.
Hold short, Echo Fox 8 Golf.
Kind of just working my way through the airplane that I've got to see which ones work and which ones don't with Vulcan.
Charlie 1799, Charlie 4.
Obviously, the Carinato plane so far, other than the balked instrument approach that I did the other day, everything else seems to work okay. I don't know. I did not read any of the procedures and stuff for arrivals. I'll have a look at all that stuff. We'll do another flight into Aspen at some point. Here we go. Runway 33, we found it. Hold short here. Get 118.5, I need you. No. Departure. 123.8. Did I get the wrong frequency tower? 118.85. And departure 1238.
What a problem. Pressure 413, sir. Good morning. Airborne contact departure 13365, wind 3104. Clear to take off runway 20.
Clear to take off 20. 3365, airborne.
Alright, lights. Landing lights, strobes. Transponder, we got our squawk code in there. Flaps are set, trim set. Lift dump is disarmed. Take a swig of coffee and we'll go.
Alpha 4 is approved. Contact ground 1217 off of runway 30.
I feel like I'm missing something. I'm not flying with checklists. Book it. Thank you, my brother. Man, you're on a roll today, dude.
Encore 3222, exit Alpha 4 is approved. Contact ground 1217 off of runway 30.
Clear final. It's a regular takeoff. We'll just keep it rolling here. Let's go.
Tower, good morning, Columbus Golf, Mike Papa Yankee, holding short of 20.
Mike Papa Yankee, Tower, good morning, line up runway 20 and wait short delay for turbulence from the departure 737. Line up 20, wait, Mike Papa Yankee.
V1, rotate. See ya! Tap the brakes. Gear up.
Mike Papa Yankee Tower airborne contact departure 13365 clear for takeoff runway 20.
We're going to bring the flaps up.
3365 here, this is on 20. Mike Papa Yankee.
And the yaw damper, where are you at? Bam.
Mike Papa Yankee Tower airborne contact departure 13365 clear for takeoff runway 20. 3365 here.
Tower United 576, ready for departure at 20.
576, there airborne contact departure 13365, ready for takeoff runway 20. Good evening.
A sub just gives you access to that streamers, like custom emojis and stuff. It's 200 knots, we're above 10,000, so let me go ahead. I'm going to turn the autopilot on. Turn off the landing lights. And we're going to do flight level change. Get our speed down, we'll do 200 knots. See ya.
Tower Delta 22.
A new Piper Archer 3. Mainly air. You fly arrows? Which kind?
Airborne contact departure 13365 with 3206. Clear to take off runway 20.
Clear to take off 20. Departure airborne. Delta 2247.
I did my complex aircraft hours in a Piper Arrow 3. PA-28R. I'd like to fly the turbo arrows, that would be sweet. flying school. Yeah. Don't own my own plane yet.
Airborne contact departure 13365 with 3206 clear for takeoff runway 20.
Whoops. But yeah, it would definitely be kind of sketch flying in here at night, but man, it looks good during the day. Tinyaxt, thanks for the follow there, bud. Welcome. This is the Premier 1A Beechcraft.
Shuttle 6195, descend to 5000. Call arrival now 124.47. Good day.
Down to 5000, arrival air shuttle 6195. Good day, sir.
If you got ortho too, man, Colorado, one of the best places to fly. So good. When the weather's good, I guess. I love flying out here. Also, Jackson Hole is freaking awesome. They do, in terms of systems, they do. I will tell you that the Saab 340 I was generally pretty impressed with. Although, other than the ILS approach that I tried to do the other day, their planes have gotten better. The older ones, you can tell a major difference between their older planes and the newer ones. And one of the ways that you can tell is this little tab over here on the side. If you can use your scroll wheel to make that go away, usually the newer planes are a bit better. It would be cool if there was more systems depth, though, but they're not bad airplanes, especially for the price. I was going to fly the TBM today, because it would be good to do a Failure Friday with a single-engine plane, but I haven't tested it yet to make sure that it works with Vulcan, so I'm a little hesitant. I'll do that sometime this weekend.
Arrival, hello. Air Shuttle 6195, 6200, descend to 5000.
Shuttle 6195, descend to 4000, winning level 200 knots.
4200 knots on level, Air Shuttle 6195.
When was the last time it was updated? Or does it work? Did it work with default, I guess, when Vulcan came out? I haven't checked. The last time I flew that plane was probably about a month and a half ago, so I'm not even sure I have the most up-to-date version. Alright, yeah, I'll have to get that. We'll get that, we'll do a TBM flight.
On course 3409, heading 210, and set the likewise, run 24 right.
How much does a game cost over there now? And does that make flying a lot more expensive too? Holy cow, I'm getting a little turbulence here. It scared me.
On course 3409, heading 210.
Double check, there's nothing on the CAS here. Honestly, too, man, at this point, there's a lot of free stuff that you can get that's pretty good. And I mean, for example, all the ortho stuff you can do for free as long as you got the time to do it. The default airports are okay. They're not the best, but you really don't have to spend a lot of money unless you want to. I have an addictive personality in that regard and kind of got carried away with it, but that's something else that's good about Twitch, though. I mean, I pretty much... every couple months, I'll make like $100 from subs and stuff like that, and that all goes straight back into the sim, buying new airplanes and sceneries and stuff like that. I'm impressed with Vulcan. If they ever get to the point where they have volumetric clouds, I'll probably stick with X-Plane for a while. But if I were you, I mean, I might hold out and see what happens with FS2020. What are we doing? Still climbing at like 1500 feet. Let's go 190. 23,000. Oop, forgot to switch this to standard. So 1,000 Rand for just Flight Piper. So what is the rate, dollar to Rand? I'm sure you know the conversion rate. $1 is 17. Alright, I'll do some math in my head here to figure that out. But sounds more expensive.
Shuttle 6195, heading 040.
Heading 040 for shuttle 6195.
Denver Center. I have some Australian guys that I play video games with from time to time, and they talk about that, buying games and stuff like that. It sucks that it's always more expensive for them. But if you go, you know, fly an airplane in real life, like rent an airplane, is that a more normal price because you're not paying a conversion on it? No, I have, I think, Vivid Sky, which is a free add-on that you can run with the Fly with Lua thing, so it just changes the skybox colors, and I think might change the cloud textures. So pretty much everything is default, or free, I mean. I do have Active Sky, though, for a weather injector. You get 99.9% on the N2. I think you can go above 100% N2. Someone told me that, but I'm not a turbine boy in real life. So tell me about SkyMax. What is that? I've never even heard that before. Don't lie. Don't lie. We know you got lines out there. It's, you know, before when I lived in Korea, I knew a ton of, there was a ton of South Africans there, and everyone always talked really highly about the country. And it was always like talking about how great it was, and then if they were together, it would just be nothing but complaining. Kisa, annyeonghaseyo.
Tata. Bloomberg 6262, good morning, and shouldn't be anything worse than occasional light job for you.
Roger, thanks, Bloomberg.
Like we can peek through little holes in the clouds.
Bloomberg 6260, go direct Megalo on course.
Direct Megalo, Bloomberg 6262.
Places the clouds, like with what? Is it still 2D sprites though? Was that a new add-on too? Cause I saw something that was a like a weather type injector that worked with Active Sky on the store recently, but I didn't really look too closely at it. I just want volumetric clouds.
Bloomberg 6260, good afternoon, or good morning, and shouldn't be anything worse than occasional light shot for you.
Roger, thanks, Bloomberg 6260.
Bloomberg 6260, go direct Megalo on course.
Let's have a look and see what the weather is doing in Jackson Hole. KJAC. Winds 180 at 7
Canada,
knots.
Canada 448 with you.
Visibility 10. It's clear below 20,000. Temperature 3.
Be
it's almost July and it's 3 degrees. 2-point minus 6, no precipitation, altimeter 3018. Alright, so it's going to be runway 18. Let's look at what procedures we got. Procedures. Approach. So we got ILS Yankee or Zulu 19. Let's do an ILS. That way. Well, actually, weird. So, 4 flight is saying that. Let me see what the wind's doing there. 4 flight's telling me something other than active sky.
Canada 448, good day. Climb level 270. Shouldn't be anything worse than occasional light job.
Hey, dispatch mentioned that 250 and below is smooth, so requesting flight level 250 for Canada 448.
Canada 448, recruit level 250.
At level 250, Canada 448.
Weather, it's saying winds 340 at 3 knots. Oh, so SkyMax makes volumetric clouds. I may have to check that out. How much is it?
Let's
see what the ATIS frequency is here. Well, I'll get the, I don't know. Well, let's plan on runway 19. We'll do... What procedures did I say that there was? Let's see. ILS Zulu, runway 19. Via... Dunoir. DNW. That'll work. Rival ILS Zulu 19. No transition. Execute. Legs. PPI and then. What is this? Is it different than when I got on the approach plate? Is that the right one? ILS Zulu.
Air Canada 611 flight level 320.
ILS Zulu, runway 19.
Good afternoon, ATIS Pro.
Good problem. Air Canada 611, flight level 320.
Air Canada 611, flight level 320 from center. Good afternoon, ATIS Pro.
Via Dunoir, which I guess is weird. I'll do their transition. Might be a little bit longer. Execute, legs. So I could just delete these. That's the initial approach fix on the plate is Dunoir, so I'm going to delete.
Bye-bye.
Oh, shit. And you. And we'll put Dunoir. And, yeah, that's the next one. Zibib. There we go. So the real weather is, I have active sky. Would that be the real weather connector, right?
349 for flare.
BPI, we're just going to do direct to Dunoir. So Dunoir, copy. Make sure no discontinuities. And once we get a little bit closer, I'll brief that approach. I'll just leave it up for
now. 952, contact me, 133.72.
Favorite war movie with planes? What do you mean with planes? Like what kind of? There aren't many that I know. Wow, look at that view. Jesus. The only ones that I can think of that are like, does, what's it called? The Final Countdown? Is that the one where they send the aircraft carrier back in time to right before Pearl Harbor happened with the F-14s and the Zeros? Does that technically count? Okay. Oh, I see. So you gotta pay like another $50 for all that kind of crap. I'll just wait. These clouds are doable. They're passable. Let's see what the ATIS frequency. Jackson 120625. Put that in COM 2.
952, Roger, at your discretion, descend 6,000.
Double check the volume.
the cold wave altimeter 2970.
Memphis Belle, that was a good one. The special effects were kind of cheesy, but that was pretty good. Yeah, I guess I mean that the final countdown doesn't really count because it wasn't based on a real event. Yeah, I'm kind of the same. Not a huge movie person. Although I will say Top Gun, probably like many of us, was the movie that got me into aviation in the first place. Airwolf. That was a good one. That's a classic from my childhood. Jeez. All right, ground speed 380. Let's look. We need a Dunoir. We need to be what altitude? All right, nearest one. So 12,900. Dang, I gotta do math again. 13,000, so we got to lose 20,000 feet, so we need to start descending about 60 miles before Dunoir. So once it's active, we'll wait a few miles and then we'll start descending. This light should have gone off. Uh-oh. That should not be on. Might have a failure, boys. But let's have a look outside and see if anything's... Everything's up, but for whatever reason, it's not secure. Or that circuit's not completing. Hey, as long as it comes back down, right? That's all I'm really worried about. Can't cycle it. I mean, like I said, hit it really quick. But at these speeds, obviously, I wouldn't want to be putting them down. Well, we'll see what happens as we get a little bit closer. I don't think that there is a manual... Let me turn my external volume down. Sorry. I don't think that there's a manual... I'm going to lock that, too. A manual gear extension that I'm aware of in the Carinato planes. And I'm not going to pull up the user manual. Yeah, I've done it worse. Also, that's the whole point of Failure Friday. We wanted to get a failure. It's a pretty decent one to have. Let's brief this approach. Again, assuming that we're still going to get this when we get there. Although, hopefully we'll pick up the ATIS before we get to whatever that VOR, BPI, because the differences in initial approach fix are like pretty significant because of terrain. We're flying way out of our way if we get the wrong one. Might just land there anyway on 19. Localizer frequency 109.1. Let me make sure my plate's up to date. Good until July 16th, 2020. We're good. Localizer frequency 109.1. Approach course 187 degrees. Runway length 6,300. Touchdown zone elevation 6,451. Airport elevation 6,451. Non-standard takeoff minimums don't need. Alternate minimums not applicable. Glitch Gaming, thank you.
6940, roger, check your canceling IFR. Surveillance service coming with me, cleared on our frequencies, call me on the ground to close out, company traffic.
Missed approach, climb to 6900, then a climbing right turn to 14,000 on the Jackson VOR DME radio 192 to Kitchney intersection, 26.6 DME, and hold. Continue climb and hold to 14,000. Missed approach requires minimum climb of 235 feet per nautical mile. It's no problem. Got our ATIS on there. Put Salt Lake Center on the approach for comm recall. So 133.25. Jackson Tower, 118.075. Ground, 12455. Dunmore, 12,900, then the approach starts from there to Zibiv at or above 11,000, Zosev at or above 9,800, Wimru at or above 8,700, and the glide slope intercept at 8,000 at Yusku.
We're
probably going to be class Bravo,
yeah,
class B, so minimums, all classes, straight in, ILS, runway 19. 6,651 and 4,000 feet runway visual range. Pretty straightforward. I'm actually past Eaker, so this needs to be nav 1.
Jazz 221 is with you, level 250.
Jazz 221,
Hunter
Guinea.
Jazz
2-0-0. We just lost engine number one.
What's your best forward indicated airspeed you can do for me today?
What we got going on here? There we go, boys. Is there a fire? No alarms. Alright, let's cut this guy off. And I need to see if there's an airport around here. What can we land? Where can we, oh, shit. KCAG is behind us. Hang on, let's get this ATIS tuned in. We're gonna go. Let me see how long the runway is. Dude, I don't know. Moffitt. Oh, yeah, dude, that's an airport base, right? It's KCAG.
Jazz 513, good day. See your indicated airspeed.
Working 245 for Jazz 513.
6,000 feet, so let's go 8,000. Let's get us down to 10 and I'll fly the rest of it manually. Vertical speed. Well, that's the first time I've had an engine failure. And let's do this flight plan. Moffitt KCAG. Go into heading mode here. Was that behind us, right? Let's get turning. Glitch came in. Thank you, brother. I need to pull up an airport chart for that one real quick so I can double check that we got enough runway to land there.
16.5, climbing flight level 210.
Delta 2247, enter good day, climb flight level 280.
Climb flight level 280, Delta 2247.
Airport diagram, please. 5,600 feet, that'll do. Runway 07 and 25. Go direct. See if we get an ASOS or something there.
Hello, Westchester 204 within the climb of 13.2 Greg Moffitt weather. Wind, mic, and variable. Visibility more than 10.
Sky clear. Temperature 0. Dew point minus 7. Altimeter 3032.
3032. So I put 7700 on the transponder. So we got an engine failure. We might not even have landing gear when we get there.
Craig Moffat weather.
Light and variable.
Light and variable. Visibility
doesn't matter what
more
procedures
than 10.
Do we have.
Sky clear. Temperature 0. Dew point minus 7. Altimeter 3032.
Let's see, procedures. Approach. Let's do the RNAV direction we're heading right now.
Let's
go RNAV 07.
Approach, cross restriction at move, still in effect.
Actually, we're just going to fly this by hand.
We could probably cancel the ISR, actually. That might be helpful.
9852, Roger, okay, check your canceling IFR. Company traffic now on a, what looks like, 9 miles.
Lost engine number one. There's no fire, it just stopped. I'm gonna go external for a second, so ear warning. So now we got two issues. The landing gear may or may not come down, had some sort of failure there, and engine number one is gone.
Sierra Whiskey Uniform, you cleared out of control airspace in the vicinity of Black Labish. 25 nautical mile minimum safe altitude, 4,400.
See what some refs are.
Cleared out of control airspace, no say on this one, safe 4,400, closed out with the RC on the ground.
Sierra Whiskey Uniform, Roger, I checked the remarks, no radar observed traffic between you and the field surveillance service.
So approach speed is 120 knots. With one engine, I'm guessing you're probably not going to want to use a lot of flaps. Can we see this puppy? Where are you at? Was the altimeter there again? 3032. Winds 187 at 4. Four S light and variable, it doesn't matter. It's gonna be better for runway 25 though.
Jazz 331 ready to send 10,000, the emission altimeter 29er.
Yeah, that would be bad. Having to do an instrument approach with one engine. Miles. Anybody see an airport? Still pretty high.
Delta 2247 contact center 134.9. Good day.
At least it wasn't an engine fire.
Delta 2247 contact center 134.9. Good day.
34.9 Delta 2247. Good day.
Where the F is this airport?
Westjet 204 contact center 134.9. Good day.
34.9 Westjet 204. Take care.
I should be 1 to 2 o'clock at 20 miles. Hello? I don't know, boys. Just keep heading direct to until I can see it. Let's get the barrel 3032.
Westjet 204, contact center 134.9. Good day.
34.9, Westjet 204, take care.
So make sure the seatbelt signs are on. Seatbelt, no smoking. All right, like 15 miles at 1 o'clock. Where the F is this airport? Hope it's not a grass strip. Yeah. There's an instrument approach, so it has to be paved. Miles, 2 o'clock. I have no idea where it is. Well, obviously, I mean, there's an instrument approach somewhere. I just gotta be able to see the freaking airport, right?
2485, Jazz, you two on, yeah.
Well, anybody? Anybody see an airport?
Center Chinook 9402 on the ground.
Chinook 9402, Roger. Close your flight line. Good day.
62.
Let's do this. Oh, no. KCAG. Arrivals, RNAV 25, no transition. There we go. Execute legs 9,300 at chemo. So let's get ourselves.
Center Chinook 9402 on the ground at Compton.
Chinook 9402, Roger. Close your flight line. Good day.
62.
Approach mode, that'll give us some enunciation. I'm just gonna follow this. I'm gonna take the autopilot off too. Hello?
On course 3211, when ready to send 10,000, and the altimeter 29 or
so. The N2 on engine 2 is like 99%, and we're still like pretty good on airspeed.
We'll give you our best speed and descend on course 3211.
What happened to our flight director? Flight director approach.
On course 3211, when ready to send 10,000, MH altimeter 29 or 79 for spacing, best forward speed in the descent.
10,000 ready on 29 or 79, we'll give you our best speed and descent on course 3211.
So 9,300 at Kima, that's 5 miles up here. Oh, master caution. What is that? Oh, left gen, that's fine. Didn't have that anyway.
Encore 4066, center, good day. Your research at the Firebag Airport, by present position, direct Lexon, direct to Fort McMurray VOR, direct Dabley, direct.
Double check the altitudes we got here. 8,500 hours away, which is the next one that's behind us. So I'm going to go ahead and start descending, and hopefully we'll pick up the airport before we get there. And hopefully the landing gear come down. So below 200 knots, we can put the gear down, and I'm going to wait until we get a little bit closer to the runway, because that's going to be a lot of drag, and we'll probably just do a no-flaps landing. And I need to pause it 1 second and do too much going on here. Direct Alzoy. Direct interchange, Alzoy. Okay, can't do that. What's going on here? Fuck it.
Center, Cessna 182, Foxtrot, Sierra, India Hotel.
Cessna 182, Foxtrot, Sierra, India Hotel, Enter, go ahead.
Yeah, Foxtrot, Sierra, India Hotel.
Oh, I see it.
10 to the north of Lac La Biche at 4,000 feet on a VFR flight from Lac La Biche to Cree Lake. Just going through the north end of the base, looking for flight following through the South Oil Sands area.
Foxtrot, Sierra, India Hotel.
Also 8,500.
Currently you are below radar coverage. Are you staying at what altitude as you continue northbound?
Actually, you might even be able to do a flaps landing. Really,
hotel,
other than a little bit of roll to the right, there's not even much yaw.
Okay, Sierra, into hotel. Roger, check your marks. I'll keep watching for you there. I'll let you know when I pick you up again.
I'm going to get it below 200
and,
knots here, though.
I'll have flight following for you at that time. I currently have
double check to make
IFR
sure the lift dump is on.
For you to pass.
Sierra, into hotel. Roger that. Thank you.
Still surprisingly a lot of power with one engine. See if the landing gear is going to come down. There's 200 knots. Stow the spoilers and come on, baby. Three green. Although I'm not sure that's locked, though. I mean, it's still got a red on the actual handle. So these might collapse when we land. No parachutes, baby. And we're not going around. I'll just do a flaps 10, whatever that first position is. Trimming in a little bit of aileron just to keep it from rolling here. There's also a little bit of yaw, but it's not too bad. So I'm putting the flaps in now. We're definitely going to make the runway, and there's plenty of power, surprisingly, so. God, I floated it. Whoa! I think the gear collapsed on that one. Left oil pressure low, yes, thank you. Let's kill that guy too real fast. Well, I'm not sure if we would survive that or not. Let's have a look at the replay. See the fan blade stop spinning. They should be windmilling a little bit. Is this us? Nope. This is us. Other professionals. See how bad it looks from the outside. That'll determine whether or not we lived. Just figure if you caught the wing and it started spinning or dragging on the ground, it might have broken off and caused a fire or something, but who knows. That was also not the time to float a landing. I think that was probably survivable. Plane's definitely totaled. So we pay them premiums for a boy? Imagine how much the insurance cost on a Premier One. Folded like a cheap suit. I don't know, what do you guys think? Do we survive or no? See that wing view from the left wing.
Control that one first, Jazz 513, descend to 10,000 when ready, and an altimeter 29er, 79er.
Shuttle 10, 10,000, I'll discuss Jazz 513.
Oh, definitely. New seats, new pants. Put it on the list, dude. Like you said, though, fortunately, the weather was cooperative. That would have been kind of hairy doing that in IMC. Yeah, I'm gonna say we survived. Although, I also imagine in real life, if that wing, like once you got off the runway and it dug into the grass or the soft ground, if it didn't rip the wing off completely, it could have spun the plane around and caused it to start tumbling or stuff. But based on what I saw right there, I'm going to say we survived that one. Survival. We diverted. We lived, I think. Should have had the fuel pumps off before we were on the ground, but hindsight, et cetera, et cetera. Boys? So I think the default here, I'll pull it up real quick. Let me see exactly what we had fail. The default setting is 1, I think, 1,000, which means that there's a 1 in 1,000 chance every hour that an individual system will fail. So I set it to 350. So there's a 1 in 350 chance, if I understand this correctly, every hour of each system failing. So let's look through here and see what we got exactly. If I'm on the right menu. Hold on a second. Edit failures, here we go. Yeah, you might have gotten a little bruised up. We didn't tumble or anything, so. Left main gear actuator collapsed. We knew that. Lights don't care. Instruments. See what happened precisely with the engine. Co-pilot altimeter, that's no big deal. Engine. Ah, so the FADEC went out. And a clogged nozzle for engine number one. Alright, that's not too bad. That was probably my most decent failure. Usually you end up landing and you're like, alright, what happened to the failures? And you get there and like, your pitot tube got blocked or something stupid. Alright, boys, I'm gonna get out of here. Short little stream. Short and sweet. Thanks for hanging out. Glitched Gaming TVS, thank you so much for being very generous today. Ashton, nice talking to you guys. Be back. We'll probably be back tomorrow and Sunday as well. Not flying this weekend, which I should have told you about, Esther. I'll tell you guys tomorrow. Talk to you guys later. Have a good weekend. We'll see you tomorrow. We love you. See you next time. Peace.